it's a perfect example that you just never know what's lurking beneath the surface. And even if you squint at this painting, you are still not going to see it, because it takes a high-powered gizmo to spot the masterpiece behind the masterpiece. There's a hidden painting, y'all, beneath one of Pablo Picasso's first works of art. This is the Blue Room. He created it back in 1901, real early in his career, while he was working in Paris, starving artist and the whole bit. In 1954, a conservator said, I don't think so, something's a bit off. The brush strokes just aren't working for me. But it was gonna take decades before there'd be new technology that could pave the way for the detective work to really kick in. And for the first time, the Phillips Collection in Washington, D.C. is revealing what was hiding beneath the painting. It's a man wearing a bow tie, his bearded face resting on his hand, but no one knows who the man is. I want to bring in Susan Frank. She's the associate curator of research for the Phillips Collection. Susan, this is just awesome, beyond all awesomeness. How on earth did they actually find the hidden painting?
Well, this is such an interesting part of any curator's opportunity at a museum, is to work with conservators and scientists to go and learn more about the object in the collection. And knowing that there seemed to be this brush strokes that did not match the composition that we see on top, and scientific analysis in the mid-90s at the National Gallery, who collegially worked with us to take x-rays of the painting.
Is that what it is? The gizmo is actually just kind of, you know, pro forma x-ray, or is it something more special than that?
You can do a pro forma x-rays, which was done back in the mid to late 90s, and then about 6 years ago, technology had improved so that digital infrared camera revealed a much more complete image of this unknown man that is the painting that precedes the Blue Room that we have all known for so many years.
So one of the things, Susan, I wanted to ask you is that I always wonder if artists back then did this to be sneaky, or did this because they were broke and they didn't have enough canvases. So they would work on something and then they'd say, you know, I'm going to start all over and just use the canvas I have.
Well, it's certainly with Picasso, it was a period in his life when he was broke and he needed to repurpose canvases. Whether this was a portrait of an individual and he thought he might be able to sell it, or whether it was just something he did that was an individual who had captured his imagination. Picasso
Amazing.
Is an artist who worked so quickly and had so many ideas that reusing these canvases to capture a current idea was like part of his process.